Are you happy to be here?
Yes.
Are you happy to be in the presence of the Most High God?
Yes.
Amen. It's great to see you guys. We are not wasting time. Please stand up now as we welcome the pastor for our all night. Amen. Put your hands together as we welcome him. Shut up.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Can we begin to appreciate this God?
Thank you, Lord.
Can we begin to glorify his name? Can we begin to thank him for allowing us to see Kabuska Praya Katuyaba? Another day, another end of the month. Taka Sakataya, Satanaba Shambadaya, Nimaloku Tuya Baba. Where would we have been without him? Mosekitiya Bukuri. What would have been our testimonies without him? Can we just begin to appreciate him? Let's begin to thank him. Let's begin to glorify his name. Remember, you are the one that gives him power. You are the one that gives him power. Rimbarambo Rogodo, Uriya Kakari, Ribaku Sekite. You are the one that empowers him. Shabla Kamuku Sekite Yabu. Rimbaraba Boku Rimbaraba. Empower him tonight to bless you. Empower him tonight, tika tika tonya, to do extraordinary for you. Empower him tonight, shibra kutere moshamba liyada, ibali brokuto mokoya. Empower him tonight, ibaro kudoya moshemiteya, riboro kudo mokuri marada. Church, empower him tonight, to do the extraordinary for you, in the name of Jesus. I am excited. Church, do you know why I'm excited? I'm excited because something great is happening. I'm going to share something tonight that if you understand it, your life will never be the same. Let's just begin to thank him. Thank him. Thank him because this month, the Archbishop has declared it as our month of uncommon favor. Uncommon favor. And I'm teaching tonight a level that is above the level of uncommon favor. You know, in as much as this is our month of uncommon favor, church, I'm here to declare to you that as you enter the month of April, you are entering into a level that is above the level of uncommon favor.
Amen.
God is going to do some powerful things through your hands in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, I thank you for tonight.
Thank you, God.
I glorify your name for tonight. Be thou exalted. Bring your word to, oh God, to light, so that your people will understand you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Be thou glorified, be thou magnified in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Be seated, church. This month that is ending is our month of kind of reaching out to people, making people know God, because this is Church of God Mission Global Evangelical Month. But in line with what the scripture says, because when you go out, it kind of, you will perish if you do not go out. Any church that doesn't embark on evangelism is dead. It's just like when you are selling books and all the book that you have in your bookshop is only Bible. You are not trying to buy other books that will, you know, attract people, all this stuff. Only you are selling Bible only. Yeah. So that is it. You have to upgrade. The same way any church that doesn't go out for evangelism, that doesn't live for evangelism, is what? They will go out of business. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Does that make sense?
Yes, sir.
Praise the Lord. So, this month is our month of uncommon favor. First of all, I want you to understand what the Bible is talking about uncommon favor. Can you go to the book of Psalms? Go to the book of Psalms, 102, verse 13. Psalms 102, verse 13.
Thou shalt arise and have mercy upon Zion.
Yeah.
For the time to favor her. Yea, the set time is come.
I want us to understand typically what it means to live in an uncommon favor. The time to favor Zion has not what? Has come. It's time for you to arise, God. Now, understand, how does the favor come? Let's read it again. Just tell me, what's the source of the favor?
The Lord shall have mercy first.
Read it again, son.
Thou shalt arise.
Where?
And have mercy upon Zion. For the time to favor her, yea, the set time is come.
Does it mean that favor will just be flowing to you? Or will there be something that will happen before you get the favor?
Something that will happen.
So there will be something that, there is something that should happen before you get the favor, right?
Yeah.
So it's conditional. Is it? Just we are coming out. Because I want you to, if you don't understand, you don't understand my message. Read it again and tell us the condition, the two conditions that will be in place before you get that favor written there.
Thou shalt arise. And have mercy upon Zion.
And do what?
Have mercy upon Zion.
God will first of all arise. He needs to finish his coffee first, you know? Finish his breakfast. When he finishes his breakfast, then he will brush his teeth. And after brushing his teeth, and he will now say, have you received mercy? I hope you are good. Your office is working well. God bless you. And he will say, have you received mercy? He will bring out the thermometer for mercy. And we check you. Have you received mercy? Yeah, okay. Beep, beep, beep. If it is green, when the police check you for drugs, you know? Do you know that if police catches you so many times for drugs, they will put something in your car?
Yeah.
Are you aware of that? You can't start your, you can't move your car without sucking that. And if you leave your seat, your car will stop. So, I thank God none of you take drugs, not here. You know me, Pastor. You want to scatter your bread? Good bread that was given to you from God. I want to use weed and drug. May the Lord help you. I know my children cannot do that. Church, are we getting it? Are there conditions for getting favor from God?
Amen, yes.
Are there conditions? Condition. You can't just wake up and get favor. He said, God will first of all finish his coffee. And after he has finished his coffee, he will bring that thermometer to check whether there is mercy. And when he found that he clears you, negative, green, pam, 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 you are forgiven. Pam, mercy, pam. Then he said, the time has come. He will check his time. And not is it the time? Abraham, 25 years. I'm only trying to prove to you that you can live a life beyond that. You don't need to wait for God to wake up. After taking his coffee, he will check you with thermometer for faith, mercy. Why waste your time for favor when you can live above that? Am I making sense? I hated going to church. Never knew that my pains were directing me to my passion. Because when I come to church, pastors preach nonsense. They repeat the Ten Commandments. They come from the West, introducing the Ten Commandments. They come from the South, introducing the Ten Commandments. They come from the East. I said, when I found out that I'm a pastor, I said, God, I'm not going to preach you. What will I be teaching? He said, develop yourself.
Holy Ghost, marry Holy Ghost. You don't do anything. He will remind you everything. Even if you are having 2,200 like Billy Graham, he said, I was out of message. I said, that's man. He was pocketing it in his pocket. He is missing. And when he preached this one, he found out there was no one. But when it is the Holy Ghost, Shakala, Kilaba, I'm calling that out of your belly shall flow, not cup of water, rivers of living messages. So I can't come. And most of you here have not even thought about it, that favor is conditional. Yet we call it unmerited favor. We call it uncommon favor. Yet it's conditional. If God doesn't arise, if he doesn't have this, you will not have favor. Church, you are moving beyond that.
Amen.
Are you getting it?
Yes, sir.
Our Father which art in heaven, Lord, stay in heaven. Archbishop said that also. He tapped into it. When he want to do anything, he said, God, don't waste your time. I'm here. He tapped into that bread. He said, oh God, you gave me bread so that I give you rest. Rest. I have tapped into that level that is above the level of uncommon favor. We were watching a Nigerian movie. You know, most pastors in Nigeria, they don't read the Bible again. They watch Nigerian movie to get their pattern of ministry. And when Nigerian movie, somebody witchcraft, come on, money ritual. Nigerian pastor, African pastor, will not, oh, that's where it's going now. Every money. One day, I just thank God for people like Chris Oyakodone. He just came out. He laughed. You know, thank God for men of God. Like that. One man of wisdom, a powerful teacher. He laughed. Everybody was saying, Pastor, what did you take anything? Did you take carbide? Did you add your own carbide? And he laughed. And they kind of tried, let's kill the devil. Everybody. He said, let's destroy the devil. He said, Nigeria movie. That was how. He said, Nigeria. Look at what Nigeria movie have come Christians in Nigeria. Look at what Nigeria movie is the one teaching pastors how to do. This is what they are doing now. I picked it. I said, wow, this is awesome. This is awesome. I said, God forbid. Nigerian movies that should have a genuine pastor that knows the word. If you want to ask anything about Christians, if you really want to make it, go and submit it to him and say, are these principles right in this movie? But do you know what happens? Pastors go to Nigerian movies. If they are praying now and seeing the devil they are speaking in the spirit is the one in Nigeria movie that has like the ghost that when he's crossing the road, he will look where that car is coming. Nigeria ghost movie. If you watch their ghost, if they are crossing the road, they check where that car is coming. And if that is coming, they will dodge and wait. Nigeria movie ghost. Yes, that's the kind of part. And all they are seeing, they say, I've seen it in the spirit, oh, it's coming, it has big head, it has big leg, it has. My people are distressed for lack of knowledge. Do you know there is no devil on your way? The only devil on your way is the one you created but with your mind. You can't be in another kingdom, another world, and the devil is in another world. Is called Christ. Jesus said, I will not, you, some of you here will not die. You see the next second world coming. It's called the kingdom of God, Christ. And the devil is in another world. And you are in another world. Then when you are driving in your world, you are seeing devil flying. There's no devil there. It's the devil you created with your mind. It's the devil. Don't you know you have power? All power will authority has begun even to create devil. You create your own devil. And the devil will beat you and beat you and you come home and start crying. You created the devil. You gave him this to flog you. And he will flog you, shake it. Am I making sense?
Yes,
sir. I'm Bishop Wesley Elsa. No. God, I know favor and common favor, but I have something greater than that. Hallelujah. From today, you will create your own favor. You will not wait for God to wake up and brush his teeth. You will not wait for God to check your mercy before he will give you favor. You will not wait for God to check his time and say, the time has come for me to favor you. Before even God wake up, you already enjoy your favor. Before even God start checking you about your mercy, you are flowing in your favor. Before God will check his time, you are flowing in your favor. Never again. Your prayers shall be from now henceforth. Oh, before when we hear it and come on favor, we start rejoicing without the mindset and understanding that it comes with the condition. Go to Luke chapter 2, verse 52. I'm trying to bring it in all way so that you understand that these things are conditional. Now, this should be the highest level of favor. Yabaranda Bakuria. Luke 2:52. What did he say?
And Jesus increased in wisdom.
Increased in wisdom.
And stature.
And stature.
And in favor with God and man.
And increased. He also increased in favor with man and God. So does it mean that favor increased? Favor grows. Does that make sense? The first place we read, we found out that favor is conditional. The second place we are reading now, favor grows. And what did Jesus tell us when he was leaving? He said, my favor that I grew, that increased between men and God was 50% or 100%. He said, greater. He said, your own can grow 150. He said, he grew. He increased. So favor increases. So there's one level of favor, and there's another level of favor. But Jesus even himself says, don't ever limit yourself to the level of favor I enjoyed on earth. You can increase. So the Master now has given us a head up that we can do greater. You say, yeah, greater things. Greater favor can you enjoy. Now look at a man like your pastor, because this is just 100%, because that was exactly what happened to me this weekend, this morning. I didn't see this thing before even Mama gave us that key. God has already shown me. I put it on Facebook. Last week I saw Okechukwu. Okechukwu means God's godly portion, God's portion for you. I saw it, ask my wife, I'm not going to say it here, it's dangerous, what I saw. But you're going to hear about it. You're going to see what is going to happen. You're going to see what have taken men more than 20, 30 years in this nation. I'm going to achieve it in 1 year. I'm going to achieve it in 1 year. What have taken many great men here? What has even made men, they can't go back to Africa again because they are locked up. Why? Because I'm walking beyond favor. I'm moving in a level that is beyond uncommon favor. There are people, if they see favor today, their whole story as prayer has been answered. I'm above that. Because favor comes with condition. until it has timing. And favor can grow. You can't just settle. I can't settle with any kind of favor. Some people are settling with the favor of having a car. Favor of, I'm not settling with that. The fact is unlimited. Now go to Acts of Apostles chapter. Acts of Apostles chapter 7, verse 9 to 10.
Shakaboya. Burigada Makuria. Kukebeke Shekitemuri.
Fast so that we get the right message down.
And the patriarchs moved in envy, sold Joseph in Egypt, but God was with him.
They sold Joseph. Have I ever taught you that until you make a choice of whom to follow in the Bible, you have not started? Peter said, your first level of Christianity is to follow man. And even Jesus practically did it. His disciples followed him for 3.5 years. When it was time, he said, it's time now to follow the one that called me. He said, I will leave you now. I have been with you. I will leave you, but I will now be in you. So when I discovered, I read, I had God spoke to me, told me about me. I checked in the Bible. I found out the same person, the same name, my son named Joseph, is the same thing God has called me to do in Church of God Mission. That's it. I'm the Joseph, the dreamer of CGMI Global. And thank God it's God that said it is no man. Do you know why people can never believe they are perfect? Because they don't know it's God that tells you you're perfect. It's not you. And if God says you're perfect, you're perfect. Even when you see your foolishness. Because he's the one that confessed.